to bore. There's nothing to do there you've not done before.
The people are tiresome.
The party's a chore.
We just couldn't stay there for 1 minute more. The weekends in London have lost all their fun.
Now Wimbledon's over.
The test match is done. Now Henley has finished.
And Ascot has run.
It's time for the country. It's time for the sun.
Where the smart people go.
If the Duchess does invite you, then you're top of the tree. Thank goodness
she did write to me. She did write to me.
The atmosphere has heightened, now we're near heaven hall.
And everything will brighten when we're all at the ball.
For me.
He's going to be a rather rich man, isn't he, Gerald?
Yes. This rather dashes our chances of scooping up the Hereford millions for ourselves, doesn't it?
Possibly.
Listen, everybody, for the news will soon be round. As family solicitor, I've run the heir to ground. There's not a doubt about it, there isn't any snag. I've dug him out of somewhere, I've got him in the bag. I've got him, he's here. And almost any moment, any blessed moment, he'll appear. That the last Lord Hereford in his youth contracted an unfortunate marriage with a most unsuitable young woman.
Yeah.
Yes, well, they soon parted and she died. There were rumors of a son, however. Therefore, the late Lord Hereford's will had to provide for the possibility of his one day turning up. I have to tell you all, it is quite certain that he has turned up.
Well, wheel him in. Let's see what he looks like.
Does he know yet who he really is?
No, I felt it should be broken to him gently.
Is he tall? Is he fair?
Do you think we shall care for the new Lord Hereford?
Is he short? Is he tall? Do you think we shall fall for the new Lord Hereford?
Won't you tell us if you can what you know about the man?
Is he what we all expect?
Is he circumspect?
Is he weak?
Is he strong?
Does he really belong? Is he all he should be?
Well, very soon you will see.
Well, I do.
Welcome to Hereford, William.
Cheers, Squire. Gotcha.
May I present Her Grace, the Duchess of Deed?
Oh, nice to meet you, lady. Very nice indeed.
How do you do?
May I introduce you to an old friend of the family, Sir John Tremaine.
Watch me, old cock. How you doing? All
good
right?
Good Lord. I expect you'd like a drink.
Oh, rather.
Careful! That decanter is over 200 years old.
Oh, thank God for that. It could have been a new one.
My granddaughter, Lady Jacqueline Carstone.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Nice to meet you.
Yeah. Very nice to meet you, too. Very nice at all. Mwah.
Her fiancé, my nephew, Gerald Bolingbroke.
How do you do?
Oh, sorry. I dropped my cigarette in your drink.
Oh, how disgusting.
Mr. Parchester, you already know. And this is Sir Jasper Tring.
Who's that? Hey!
Very pleased to meet you, Sunshine. Yeah. Me mates call me Bill.
Right? Shall we proceed, Your Grace?
Sit down, please, will you?
Yeah, tell very much. And will it?
Before we tell you why you are here, we would like to know something about you, William.
Where do you live?
I live in a distant village called London.
Yes, but what part?
All of me.
What part of London, you clot?
Lambeth.
Lambeth?
Good Lord.
Where's Lambeth?
It's the best part of London, Squire. Just south of Warford, north of Brixton, right next to a chum.
In a house or flat?
Well, I've got a parlour, a drawing room, dining room, a kitchen, bedroom, bathroom. All in the same room. You see, the bath is in the sink. One day you bath your top part, the next day you bath your middle part, and the third day you bath your best part.
What do you live on?
Me wits.
You must be severely undernourished. Now look, what exactly do you do?
Do? Well, I'll do anything, Squire. I do a bit of sparring and again, you know. I'll run for a bookie. I sell fruit off a bearer. Yeah. Fruit off a bearer! Oily, all fresh! Ripe strawberries! Hi. Yeah. And then a bit of quickness of the end deceives the eye. Gather round. Take a card, any card. Wait! Do I know this man?
No,
I do not know this man. Take a card, any card. Go on. Look at it. Memorize it. Now, don't tell me. What is it?
Five of spades.
Correct! Yes! The man wins a gold award.
But that's my watch. He lifted my watch. Let's just get on with it, shall we?
What do you know about your parents, William?
Well, they're brown bread.
Brown bread?
What are you talking about, brown bread?
Well, I said brown bread. They're dead.
Oh! It's Cockney rhyming slang! I say,
you're trying to tell us your parents are dead?
Yeah, like I said, brown bread. I snuffed it! Well, that is, if I ever had any parents, because, well, I think I was spontaneous, you know what I mean?
Not quite.
Well.
The facts are these. Yes. Oh!
What?
Your late father was the Earl of Hereford.
What?
You are his only son. Therefore, William Alexander Henry Charles Augustus Prestine Snibson, you are now by right and lawful succession the 18th Baron Haveringland.
Well.
High steward of the Brandyston Estuary.
That's very nice.
Marshal Royal in Ordinary to the Marquisate of Snetterton. Well. And the 14th Earl of Hereford.
Yep, all right. Get away. You're pulling my tinkler, ain't you? Eh?
Nothing could be more serious.
Oh.
Good Lord, he's fainted. Quick, water.
Here, I didn't faint for water.
Branded
it. Yeah, cheers, Gav. Much obliged. Oh, how very kind of you. I'll just take this then, mate.
This is your family. Your father, the 13th Earl, was my brother. You may therefore refer to me as your Aunt Maria. Jacqueline and Gerald are your cousins.
My family? Well, now, me and Nob are belted Earl. Hey, does that mean I got a lot of bees, then?
I'm sorry?
You know, bees and honey. Money, eh?
Well, you have about £100,000.
That's not bad now, is it?
A year.
Well, I'll just take this year's instalment and be off then.
It's not as simple as that.
You're not allowed to touch the inheritance.
Yeah, how much?
The money. Yeah. Unless the executors of your father's will, that is Sir John here, and myself, are agreed that you are a fit and proper person to stay on here as Master of Hereford.
What? Me fit and proper for you lot? Forget it.
I will educate you. I am confident you will learn to rule Hereford.
Impossible! Look at him! You can't make a silk purse out of a sow's ear.
William, I'm going to make you into a gentleman. If you do as I bid you, blood will tell.
If you don't, blood will flow.
There have been Herefords here as lords of the manor for 700 years. You are the last of the line. You will stay here and perpetuate the family.
Perpetuate? Coarse truth. Well, wait till I show this lot to Sally.
Sally?
Yeah,
she's my girl. Hi. She's not out, can I love all this?
This Sally, is she also from
Lambeth? Yeah, of course, yeah.
I should have perhaps mentioned, William, that it is a condition of your late father's will that you marry a fit and proper wife.
Oh, no, no. Sally's fit and proper for me, all right. Oh, I'll bring her with me in a car. I'll fetch her in. Hey, Sally!
Don't do that.
Well, all right. Don't get your knickers in a twist. You better take this back, mate.
He took it again.
Just one moment.
Yeah.
The will states that you must marry someone of your own class.
Well, that's all right, then, because Sally is my own class.
Not any longer. You may bring her in and tell her who you really are, and then the car will take her back to London.
Oh, yeah. Well, we'll see about that, me old fruit. Hey, me old fruit! Sally!
Well!
Good Lord, Maria, you can't let him take over this house.
It is his birthright. He was born to be an earl.
But he was brought up to be a wastrel, an idler, and a layabout.
And what is the difference?
But what are we to do?
Mr. Parchester is here to advise.
Yes, dear Mr. Parchester, please do advise.
As the family solicitor, here's my advice to you. As the family solicitor, here's what you ought to do. For 6 and 8, I'll put you straight when anything goes wrong. For I contend you must pretend that life is one sweet song. So, sing a little and dance a little, be gay a little and play a little. Bring your troubles more and more to the family solicitor. Say a little and think a little and eat a little and drink a little. Keep a drop of the 94 for the family solicitor. He'll take all your cases, keep you in your places, maybe save your faces. Hop a little and skip a little and jump a little and rip a little. Thank your lucky stars once more for the family, the family, the family solicitor. He'll take all our cases,
keep us in our places,
maybe save our faces.
A little and skip, a little and jump, a little let rip, a little. Thank your lucky star.
stars once more for the family solicitor. Hop a little and skip a little and jump a little and rip a little. Thank your lucky stars once more for the family.
Thank you, Parchester, for that completely useless advice. I shall take a walk in the rose garden to compose myself.
Maria must be stopped. Damn it, I want that man out of this house. There must be something we can do.
Well, I suppose we could examine the original will.
The original will.
The original will.
The original will.
Hey, see if we can't find a loophole.
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 It's in the library.
What are we waiting for? The library.
Wait for me.
Jackie, if William does take over this house, whatever are we going to do?
Well, you could get a job.
I'm sorry?
You know, work.
Work? Jackie, please, don't be disgusting. Good lordy, work? Me? Disgrace the family name? Get up before noon? You must be off your chump. There must be better ways of raising money than that.
Well, you could try selling this.
But Jackie, that's our engagement ring.
Sorry, darling, I can't afford to mix business with pleasure. If our new Lord Hereford is going to get the money, then I'm going to get our new Lord Hereford.
Well, you've bally gone and broken my bally heart. I hope you're satisfied.
Me, I'm for the top of the tree. Just you look on and you'll see what's going to happen to me. I want all that money can buy. I'll make my limit the sky. This is hooray and goodbye.
They've gone.
Yeah.
Now come on in.
Okay.
Open your eyes and clock this.
Cor, blimey, it's the bleeding rat.
Here, mind your language, my girl.
Ooh.
Hey, would you care to dine with me, Miss Smith?
Oh, Bill, it's huge. It's bigger than the British Museum.
It's cleaner and all. You could eat your dinner off that floor.
Oh, Bill, I still can't believe it.
Well, it's true. Yeah. My aunt's a duchess. Well, you know what that makes me, don't you?
Dutch.
Yeah. Oh, Sally, I'm one of them. I'm a lord, okay?
Oh, and this is your house.
It's my house. Oh. Well, it's our house.
Okay? Oh, right. All right.
Sally?
Theo!
Hello, are you?
Hello.
Well, it's not very homely, though, is it?
I'll soon change all that when we're married. Yeah, I'll clear out all this old rubbish.
Yeah. Yeah, bung up a nice bit of flowered wallpaper or something.
Yeah, yeah. Look, shove in some new furniture.
Yeah.
Ooh, some net curtains.
Oh, yeah.
Bit of linoleum.
Oh,
wow. Bill, we'll have a lovely motor car.
No, not often. Hey, you'll be my, Now, what's an Earl's wife called?
An Earless.
You'll be my Earless.
Bill, yeah. Bill, when I'm an Earless, I won't have to work at the fish market no more.
I'll leave it out, girl. You won't have to work at all.
Aye, you can get your fingers manacled.
Oh, and me toes chiropodized.
Yeah.
And you'll buy me lots of scent.
Oh, of course I will. We'll get rid of that fish smell somehow, girl.
When I smell luscious,
yeah.
We can sit in the posh seats in the cinema.
Cool. It's all a dream, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I have got to be educated.
Educated?
Yeah.
Who says?
Who says?
Yeah.
What you mean, who says? The executors. That's my aunt and Sir John.
Are they the executors?
Yeah, not half. Hey, you know, I got a lot to learn.
Yeah.
I got to work fast and do a lot of, you know, perpetuating.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Well, where do I fit in?
Well, what do you mean, girl?
Well, I mean, am I going to be staying here as well?
Well, perhaps you could stay at a pub nearby, just for a few nights. Sally is that Duchess. She's a bit of a dragon, she is. Hey, we'll sort something out.
Bill, look, all this, it ain't gonna part us, is it?
Oh, now, what you talking about? Nothing's gonna part me and my girl.
Yeah, well, if they made you marry one of their lot, I'd die an old maid.
Sally, I couldn't live without you.
Oh, I couldn't live without you, Bill.
You're all I've got. Life's an empty thing. Life could be so awful lonesome if you're always on your own. Some life's an empty thing.
Life's a different thing. Oh, when you found your one and only, and you feel no longer lonely, life's a happy thing.
Everything was topsy-turvy, life seemed all wrong. But it came all right as soon as you came along. Me and my girl, meant for each other, sent for each other, and liking it so. Me and my girl, it's no use pretending. We knew the ending a long time ago. Some little church with a big steeple, just a few people that both of us know. And we'll have love,
yes.
Laughter, be happy ever after.
Happy ever after. Me and my girl.
of laughter. Be happy ever after.
Good afternoon, my lord.
Here, watch me, old cock. How you doing, all right?
Bill, are thy wax works?
No.
There are charrettes.
It is the bleeding Ritz.
I am Heatherset, your lordship's butler. Allow me, please, sir, on behalf of the staff, to welcome you to Hereford, my lord.
Lummy, Bill, we called you my lord.
Well, I know. Leave it to me. Thank you very much. Cheers, Gov. This is Sally.
Oh, pleased to meet you, I'm sure. Ever so.
Aperitif, my lord.
I'm sorry, I beg your pardon.
Aperitif.
Well, no thanks, I got me own. Hi. You haven't got a cigarette, have you?
Cigarette, certainly, my lord.
Oh, can Sally have one and all?
Yes, sir, they are all yours.
Aye?
Everything here is the property of your lordship.
Who sell? Take the old box,
Bill. Oh, Bill.
Well, take the bleeding box, then.
Bill.
It's all mine now, isn't it?
Oh, right.
Now, you're sure this is all mine?
Everything here is the property of your lordship.
Well, don't argue with the man, Sal. Let's grab all this stuff.
All right. Excuse me. Mm-hmm.
All right. I'll take that, then. Oh, really?
Would you care for a box? My lord?
A box? Now don't be daft. I've got enough to carry as it is. A bit, would you please, Charlie?
Pleasant ride, my lord.
Pleasant ride?
I'm going to have to put that horse on a diet. It'll take me weeks to straighten out these legs. Oh, I'll just take this. Ah, dear, oh dear. What's that?
It's bean soup.
Well, I don't care what eats bean. What is it now?
Oh. Her Grace thinks your lordship is too convivial with us.
Too convivial? Well, she's not going to come down here now, is she, eh?
Indeed not, my lord. Your lordship is the first member of the family ever to have been down here.
Do what?
It is quite unheard of, my lord.
Quite unheard of? I don't know what's the matter with you, lord. Cool, blimey. You know, the family look down on me, and you lot look up at me. Good. I'll tell you. I thought I was taller than that. I think I'll go down to the old rub-a-dub-dub.
What, my lord?
It's a pub to see if Sally's all right.
Her Grace does not approve of your visiting Miss Smith at the rub-a-dub-dub.
I overheard Her Grace saying she intends to part you and Miss Sally, my lord.
Infamy! Infamy! They've all got it! Infamy! I'm seeing rather a lot of you lately.
I thought we might meet this morning, as Mummy has suggested I take you in hand. To teach you about art. Ooh, and literature. Oh, and life. Ooh. Bill, there's so much I want to show you.
Yeah, I can see that.
Great writers and painters and poets. Do you like Kipling?
I don't know. I've never kippled.
Bill, you and I are soulmates. I can look deep into your eyes and see what you're thinking.
Then why don't you slap my face?
You're a man.
Well, this is true.
I'm a woman.
Oh, my God, so you are. Not off as clearly as I just did, girl.
I'm sailing away with you. I'm abroad.
You certainly are.
To Italy. Ah, Florence, beautiful Florence. Just we two making love.
What? You and Florence?
You kiss me on the piazza.
So I missed.
Bill, it's useless to resist. Can't you feel my heart pounding?
Aye, aye, aye.
Now, don't say all that again. Someone might come in.
Let them come in, Bill. Let the whole world come in. What have I got to hide?
Well, you've got, And then there's Piazza.
Oh, Bill. If only you knew how long I've been waiting for you.
Get off. I was only downstairs.
How I've looked for someone who plays upon my heart like you. Tall and dark and handsome. And sweet. Someone who would take my heart, maybe tear my soul apart. See, I lay myself.
No, it's impossible. I might put my arm round you. Do the things that most men do. Men not so high-minded as I. I can't do that caveman stuff. Sock 'em hard, treat 'em rough. Mother wouldn't like me to try.
You would if you could. You could and you should. And you would if you could.
But I don't.
I'm sure that you do. Just look at the view.
And
you would if you could.
But I won't.
Shame. I'd like to see you falling for me.
I would if I could.
Bill, you could, and you should, and you would if you could. Bill!
No! Jackie! I really think it's out of the question.
Hello, Gerald.
Just giving William an etiquette lesson.
Really? Jackie, I'm shocked. I'm astonished. I'm amazed. I'm a startled person.
Gerald, do you mind?
Yes, I do. I'm staggered and jiggered and profoundly disturbed. I'm going upstairs to bathe my temples in eau de cologne.
Hello, Sal.
Bill, would you have the goodness to present my compliments to Lady Jacqueline and tell her I'd like to have converse with you alone?
William, please
tell Miss Smith. I was just leaving. I detect an odor of prudishness in the room.
The smell to what her lightiness is referring, William, seems to come from some cheap French scent in the neighborhood of that settee.
Perhaps Miss Smith is not aware, William, that such gross impertinence betrays her obvious lack of breeding.
Oh, thank her ladyship for me, Bill. And tell her that if I want lessons in her kind of breeding, I can go to a farmyard.
How dare you! William, I'll see you later when your little friend has gone.
That's right, dear. You run off and sew up your dress.
Oh!
Saucer of milk for Miss Smith.
She don't half get my dander up that one.
Yeah, I know what you mean, girl. She didn't half get mine up. How's my girl?
Oh, I'm fed up staying at the pub, Bill. And I don't like coming around, dear. The Duchess don't want me.
The Duchess? Hey, look, it's my house. If you go, I go.
No, Bill, she's right.
Oh, no.
As long as I'm around, you can't grow into a gentleman. No, now you best just forget me.
Forget you? Forget you. Good. I could no more forget you than I could forget... what's her name here? You require a lot of looking after. That's a job in which I take a pride.
You can always make me smile, make my journey seem worthwhile.
Why not keep me always at your side to guide you? Hold my hand, no matter what the weather, just you hold my hand. We'll walk through life together, for you'll find in me that kind of a friend.
Sally! 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 Oh, gosh! Oh.
to play. Play outside.
Sorry,
Sorry.
Why are you continuing with this nonsense? Nothing you can say or do will convince me that William could be made remotely fit or proper for heaven.
We shall see. I have sent for him.
Mariah, you and I used to understand each other.
Sir John?
Remember, when we were young, we were very close in those days.
I am the Earl of Hereford, or could have you two put in the tower. Now, put me down.
Oh. Thank you for dropping by, William. Time for some more lessons.
Yeah, well, I was just going down to the pub to see if Sally's all right.
Mariah.
I hope you don't mean to thwart me, John.
Go on, John. Give her a good thwarting.
You may leave us now, Sir John. We have work to do.
Back to my kennel.
Johnny, you better take this back, mate.
Thank you.
Shook! Barchester.
That's my watch.
Barchester.
Your Grace.
No.
What's today's torture, then?
I felt we should begin with your personal correspondence.
Oi, oi, fan mail. Well, what do they all want, then?
Well, this one, for instance, is from Celia Worthington Worthington. She wants to know if you would lay her. Foundation stone for the new hospital.
Celia Worthington Worthington. I don't even know her. Know her.
The Worthington Worthingtons are one of the oldest families in England.
Well then, tell her I'll do it. Do it. Hey, what's this one here? Here.
This is a letter asking if you would help the old ladies home.
Blimey, I didn't know they were still out.
Hey, I recognise this writing. It's a letter from my old mate Bobby Barking. Good old Bobby.
Aye, listen to this. Dear my lord, this is to thank you for your wedding present of that bracelet. My missus is very proud of it and wears it on her PTO. And wears it on her PTO. What's a PTO? What is that?
What? Wrist.
No. PTO. It stands for please turn over.
I got it. And where's it on her? Wrist. We thank you for your invite, but we cannot accept because you are not in our class anymore. Well, that's marvelous, isn't it? I'm not in his class anymore. I'm certainly not in your class. I'm not in her class. Oh, yes, dear, yes. I'm in no class anymore. We have moved to a new home near the gasworks, so there is always a horrible smell from your old pal, Bob.
Come along, William. We have more important things to attend to.
But what do I do with this, Lord Cedrico?
Do you want my advice?
Oh, yeah, not half.
As the family solicitor, here's my advice to you. As the family solicitor...
That'll do, Barchester. You may leave us now.
Your Grace.
Decision. It's time local society had a chance to meet you. Tongues have wagged for long enough. To that end, I've issued invitations to a party of your succession.
Aye.
It will be a select gathering of the council. Back over our previous lessons. Good afternoon, Lord Hereford.
Afternoon. Oh, I say, dash it, toodle-pip and all that rot. I think I'll dash upstairs and bathe my temples in old doo-doo.
Oh, doo-doo.
James, put the rolls in the garage. I'll butter them later. Oh, blimey. Now, don't half rip your neck muscles out talking like that. Aye. No wonder the upper classes ain't got no chins, eh?
Yes, well, speaking like a gentleman is one thing. Behaving like one is quite another. Already you have broken 12 major and 36 minor rules of conduct. Now, here are a few simple don'ts. Don't lie down in my presence. Don't sit while I'm standing. Don't wear your hat indoors. Don't smoke without my permission. Don't have the last button of your waistcoat done up. Don't pick up cigarette ends. Don't put your hand in your pocket. Don't slouch, don't sulk. And above all, don't lose your self-control. Now that is the essence of a gentleman. William, most important. When you are the host for the evening, you must go out amongst your guests, the life and soul of the party. Now watch me.
I'm watching.
Kimberly, how are you? May I present Lord Edenbridge? You're looking lovelier than ever. What a charming dress.
Oh, yes. Very dry sherry, Harry.
Gosh! I do declare you're putting on weight.
Oh, you little saucepot, you!
Listen!
What?
The dance band is starting up!
Oh, thank God for that.
Oh, they're playing my favorite waltz!
Oh, I love
now
it!
Now you must dance like that graceful couple over there. Oh, there's Lady Lind.
Lady Lind. How are you, darling? Very nice to see you.
Go on, introduce her to some of theirs, Lord Sheringham. Call him over.
Oi, Sherry, come here, look at it.
No!
Lady Linda, could you? Would you like to walk this way, please? Lady Lind, may I present Lord Sheringham? Lord Sheringham! This is Amarilla Lynn. Amarilla, keep your knickers on, girl. My God, woman, you promised. There you stay. Stay, Amarilla. Amarilla, hi.
That'll do, William.
Amarilla, have you met my fiancée, Miss Sally Smith? Isn't she a topper?
William, Sally, of course, will not be invited to the party. It is vital you make a good impression.
Well, knock it. Of course she's coming.
Can't you see? The more you progress, the more inappropriate Sally becomes. She understands that. Now, why can't you?
Hey. What have you been saying to her?
Never mind. Suffice it to say she knows what is best for you.
Look, whatever you do to me, you'll never part me from Sally.
Well, we'll see about that in due course.
Auntie, my Lady Lynn!
Oh, I beg your pardon.
I'm sorry, madam. Now your poodle is a puddle. Sally! Watch it. I should bally dash it. Toodle pip and all that rot. Carry on, my good fellow.
You don't half ply the pot, though.
Oh, yeah? Yeah. Yeah, you know, it's easy once you get the hang of this here. Yeah, Sally, you'll never guess. There's going to be a party at the Oar for me.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, I mean, all the local nibs. Yeah. Well, it'll be a lark, don't you reckon?
Oh, well, I'm not coming. I'd only make you look stupid. Anyway, I've not been invited.
Of course you're coming. I'm inviting you.
No, Bill. I've decided I'm going back to Lambeth.
Oh,
every day you grow more and more like a gentleman, and I get more out of plies.
You sound like my bleeding aunt. Here. You don't love me anymore, is that it? Because if you go back to Lambeth, I'll only follow you.
No, look, it's...
No! You're staying here, and that's a bally fact.
Bill, oh, no, wait.
Oh, pox. Chilled. Oh!
Can I get you another drink, Miss Smith?
Oh, no thanks. Oh, it's Sir John, isn't it?
I knew the Duchess was ruining the peace of the hall. But I had no idea she was ruining your life as well. It's more vital than ever that we persuade the Duchess to let Bill go back to Lambeth.
Oh, no. No, no, but his real roots are here, not Lambeth. No, if I leave, he'll settle down.
But he'll only follow you. You heard him.
Yeah, not if I can think of some way to show him that we are now worlds apart. I've got to break it off with him.
You're very fond of him, aren't you?
Once you lose your heart, once somebody takes it from the place it rested in before. Once you lose your heart, once somebody wipes it, then it isn't your heart anymore.
Landed
make us look fools.
You already look a fool.
He'll make the family look ridiculous.
He's been schooled.
He'll cope.
This is frightening.
We mustn't lose hope.
Have you reorchestrated his table manners? Taught him not to whistle?
The Earl of Hereford!
Aunt Maria, gosh, you look absolutely ravishing. Welcome to Hereford Hall, everyone. Dash it.
Who's that?
William.
William.
Good gad.
William, may I present a very dear friend of mine? This is Celia Worthington Worthington.
Mrs. Worthington, Worthington. Delighted, delighted. Have you had a sherry, sherry? Gosh, I do declare you're putting on weight.
I beg your pardon.
William is so original.
Yes, I see. Well, I have been dying to meet you.
Yes, well, keep taking the pills. You'll get over it.
My daughter May.
Really? Thanks for the tip.
Are you enjoying your new life here?
Oh, frightfully, yes. Absolutely. Oh!
The Earl and Countess.
Oh, you're right. A blood will flow. Have you had a glass of Channel Ferry? Sherry.
Sophia, my dear. You know, Mr. Barchester.
How do you do, Mr. Barchester? I'm Lady Brighton.
Oh, I love your beach.
Now tell me, which one is Lord Hereford? I gather he's the complete outsider.
Yes, and so he is. He's a ballet outsider.
It's the Duchess I feel sorry for.
Yes, the fellow's a sow's ear. Hoi polloi. Never been, Parker. Never.
Him from some frightful Brixton girl.
Oi, Lambeth, do you mind?
I beg your pardon. Oh!
Oh! Ew. Oh! You're a quart low.
Which one is Lord Hereford?
That was Lord Hereford.
Miss Sally Smith.
What a meow, cucks! Oh, are you Lord Hereford? Seeing as how you invited me, I thought I'd come. Oh, and I brought some of our royalty along with me. This is for Polly King and Queen of Lambeth.
Yay!
Oh, and I brought some of your own mates along, and I'll know as how you'd be pleased to see them. There you go, come out here, mate.
Sally, what's all this about?
See, my lord, you wanted me to come. Now perhaps you can see me and me mates just don't fit in. So now I'm going back to Lambeth, where I belong.
Oi, oi, oi! Do you mind? That's my girl, Sally, you're talking to. Now, she's done all this to prove that she don't belong. When what she's done,
is proof that I don't belong. I'm chucking this.
William!
No, Bill, I didn't do it for this.
Sally, look, East End is East End and West End is West End. I'm off.
Do you think I'll be beaten like this? You can't leave in the middle of a party. At least stay for dinner.
You don't understand, do you? Look, you could no more walk the Lambeth way than we could walk the Mayfair way. Lambeth, you've never seen. Now, the skies ain't blue and the grass, it ain't green. It hasn't got that Mayfair touch. But that don't matter very much. We play a different way. Not like you, but a bit more gay. And when we have a bit of fun,
dinner is served.
All the little girls delighted.
What a fun for everyone, sitting in the sun all day. Rub-a-bub-a-bub-a-ding-dong, ding-a-ding-a-ding-dong-ding-dong. Walk-a-tuck-a-tee-ta, hot-cha-cha.
No.
Did those frightful Cockney people go home last night?
The Duchess packed them all off at about 2:30 in the morning.
But William stayed.
And Sally.
Sally? How dare she?
She's trying to get William to run away with her.
Eh? I thought she wanted him to stay here.
Oh, Gerald, you really don't know anything about women.
Well, I may not know anything about women, but dash it, Jackie, I like you.
She's clever, very clever. She knows if she plays the little martyr, William will want her all the more. Gerald, do you mind?
No, I don't mind. Oh.
Mummy must get rid of her.
I say, good shot.
Thank you for coming out, Sally. I wanted to speak to you before you return to London. You know it is quite impossible for William to go back to Lambeth with you.
Of course I know that. What do you think I was trying to show him last night?
Maria, you still can't mean...
Hush! You futile man! I appreciated what you tried to do. Unfortunately, it had the opposite effect. Therefore, you must go to Bill.
Maria, it crossed my mind.
Not a long journey.
You must speak to Bill and break it all finally once and for all. Tell him you no longer love him.
Yeah, but even if I leave, he'll only follow me. You heard what he said.
Oh? I think you could stop him from following you, Sally, if you really wanted to. If not...
Yeah, I know. Well, I won't spoil his chances. He means too much to me for that. Leave it to me.
You'll find him in the library.
And what's he doing there?
Well, I have persuaded him. He must wear the robes and coronet of an earl and make his maiden speech in the House of Lords. After you've seen him, I will give orders for a car to take you away to Lambeth. You must make sure he has no intention of following you.
You are a wicked, interfering old bat.
I am impervious to flattery.
You can't let her do this to you.
But she's right. Bill belongs here. I don't.
You've got to stand up to her. Show her who's boss.
She already knows who's boss. She is.
Believe it to me. I'll tell the old witch. Witch. Witch reminds me. It's my shot, I think.
Are you all right? Are you crying?
No, no, I'm okay. No, people often look like they're crying when really they're sort of laughing.
Eh?
I'm laughing.
What?
I'm laughing! Once my father said, and my mother said, and my sister said, and my brother said, there's one little thing you should certainly know when into the world you go. Take your troubles on the chin, and though you get an earful, don't despair or tear your hair. What father said, that's what mother said, that's what sister said, that's what brother said. They were certainly right in telling me so, and I think that you should know. Here's a little trick, whenever things get a little bit thick, just you take it on the chin, turn on a little grin and smile, smile. Here's a little ruse to counteract an attack of the blues, just you take it on the chin, turn on a little grin and smile. What's the use of worrying about a single blessed thing? After all is done and said, pretty soon we'll all be dead. So if we're alive, if there's a bother you want to survive, just you take it on the chin, turn why you want to survive. Just you take it on the chin. Cultivate a little grin. Just you take it on the chin. Cultivate a little grin and smile.
And your mistresses. Your lordships, your warships, your fish and chips. My noble lords, I rock. I rise to my feet on this suspicious occasion. And having risen to my feet...
Bill, you all right?
Yeah, I'm just doing some press-ups, that's all.
Oh, yeah, and look, you dropped your cornet.
Cornet? No, Sally, that's a coronet, eh?
You don't half look smart, Bill.
Do you reckon?
Yeah, but why is your get-up all trimmed with vermin like that?
Vermin? Sally, this is ermine.
Well, those look like vermin.
Yeah, they do and all, don't they? Here. Yeah. Here. There you go.
So, Bill, what's this book, then?
That is the history of the Herefords, that is. Aye, put that down. That's my family tree. It's got pictures of all my ancestors from 1066, that does.
No, I learnt all that when I was at school.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, then, you know who invaded Britain in 1066?
Of course. The Romans.
No, Sally. The Romans come over in BBC. I'm talking about 1066 AD. Anno Dominos?
Dominos.
You know, the Battle of Hastings, when Harold, on his horse with his hock in his hand, got eaten high with a harrow.
I remember now. Yeah, he put an apple on his head and he said, "Shoot, Father, I am not afraid."
No, Sally, now you're thinking of George Washington and the cherry tree.
No, I'm not.
Yeah.
No. George Washington sat under a cherry tree and discovered gravity.
Oh, girl, what are you talking about? Now, let's sort this out once and for all. See, we really started with King John.
Oh.
Now, that geezer there is Simon de Hereford.
Uh-huh.
He fought... forced the king to sign the Magna Carta in 1215 and to... and so founded a strong English constitution, see?
Right.
Then he married the king's cousin and had 14 sons.
Blimey, must have had a strong constitution.
Yeah. Sally, you see that bloke there?
Yeah.
That is Richard Hereford, otherwise known as Tricky Dicky. He fought against Joan of Arc, he did.
Joan of Arc?
Oh, yeah.
Get away. Your ancestors don't go back that far.
Now, what you talking about? She come after King John. You're getting your history all muddled.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
No, Bill. Bill, listen here. Listen, everyone knows that Joan of Arc was married to Noah.
Not that Arc. I'm talking about the French.
Yeah?
Arc, Joan of Arc. You nerd. She was a beautiful...
Oh, Bill!
She was a beautiful maiden who rode against the English with nothing but her courage, right?
Oh, I remember. She rode a lily-white horse through the streets of Covent Garden.
No, Sally! That was Florence Nightingale! Oh, that one. That is Jonathan Erford, the mad sea dog.
Sea dog?
Yeah. Explorer. He discovered Milpitas. Hi, Sally. Do you realize that Jonathan actually saw Sir Walter Raleigh spread out his cloak?
Oh, spread out his cloak? Yeah. Whatever for?
Well, Sally, don't you remember who passed over?
Oh, yeah, the Israelites.
Here. You are pretending to be more ignorant than what you actually are, ain't you?
What would I do that for?
To put me off. Like you tried last night at that party. Well, I'll tell you this, my girl, it ain't working. Nope. I'm going to do this speech, and you and I are going to get married.
Goodbye.
Now don't start all that again.
Oh, can't you see why the Duchess has stuffed all these ancestors into your nut?
Why?
She's mighting a gentleman in your bill.
Ah, she can't make a sow's purse out of a silk ear.
Can't she? She's already got you talking like the BBC.
Oh, come on.
Yeah, and walking like Douglas Fairbanks.
Now don't be so belly daft.
Can't even swear or posh. Bill, you gotta marry someone with good blood.
Well, you're not anemic.
But it's not blue, though. Is it? Goodbye, Bill.
Here. What's going on? Oh. Please, Sally, don't cry.
I'm not.
Well, don't dribble down me vermin, then.
I'll clobber you with my ancestors.
It's no good, Bill.
All right, that does it. I'm not standing here watching you cry, and I'm not having this. I'm going to sort it out with her once and for all.
You'll never stand up to her.
Oh, won't I? Well, you just watch me.
Put that down.
I just did. Now, I'm ready for her.
Once you lose your heart, once somebody takes it from the place it rested in before. Once you lose your heart,
It's absurd. You know it's absurd. No, bless or please. Sally does not arise. She simply does not arise. Presently, I shall force Sir John and the other trustee to agree, God help me, that you are a suitable person to stay on here as master of the house. Next, I shall marry you to Jacqueline.
No! No!
Love you, but she wants your title and money. Nothing wrong with that. Love. Love is for the middle classes.
Middle classes? What about the king? The king married for love.
Middle class. Middle class foreigners. The whole family. Oh, if only I could say something, if I could find words to speak. No, there you lie. Chatter, chatter, chatter. Argue. I can't get a word in edgeway.
Oh, no! Get him off me! Get him off me! You... You. Hello. Nobody cares for me. Wackadoo! Wackadoo! Wackadoo!
William!
Mm-hmm.
No, William! William, read that motto.
Nobles obligee.
No bless oblige.
No bless oblige.
Do you know what that means?
Nope, and we don't want to.
Nobility has its obligations.
Here, did you see that? That was Simon de Hereford.
There's a price to pay for land and title.
All right. Calm down. What is occurring? That was Thomas Hereford. He burnt 400 people in one day.
600 at your service.
Oh, my God.
Riches carry responsibility.
Hardly.
The story of Hereford handed down since William the Norman wore the crown. The story of Hereford through the ages tells of honor and glory on all its pages. Proud
Lord Hereford's story. Lived and died, still adding to its glory. Hereford stands where Hereford stood, thanks to men of Hereford blood. Let it go on that way.
Tell you the meaning of noblesse oblige if he's not too tight.
You should have seen the bloody pictures, John. It was all my ancestors. It was all dancing. It was Simon of Hereford giving it some of this. And Richard Hereford giving it some of that. There was a right royal bloody knees up there.
My God, you must be as drunk as I am. It's the only way with Mariah. She's like Mussolini without the charm. Thank you.
Tea! How dare you? I had an aunt once who drank tea. Dead before she saw 50.
Mind you, the steam roller didn't help matters.
Come on, my boy. Let's get squiffy.
George, she's trying to turn me into a noble.
A what?
A toffee-nosed herbert like you.
No offense.
None taken, dear fellow. You are very good help.
Oh, so are you, John. So are you.
Extraordinary. As soon as I saw you, I said to myself, Johnny.
I always call myself Johnny.
Well, that is my name. You understand? Johnny, I said, this man you're looking at here is a snotter gipe.
I think you mean gutter snipe.
This is a man I would walk a mile in tight shoes to avoid. This is an utter, unmitigated yahoo.
John, that is the most beautiful thing anyone's ever said to me. You better take this back, mate.
How do you do that?
It's a gift. I'll have another drink, me old chorner.
Righto, me old cock.
You better not let that old battle axe hear you talking like that. She'll have your guts for garters, she will.
You know, Johnny, there's not half been a lot of weird things going on in this house. You know what I mean?
Here, the Duchess is the key. We have got to get the Duchess to see Sally in her true light.
If I may suggest, Sir John.
Where the hell did you come from?
You must both stand up to her grace. Tell her, if I may use the phrase, where to go.
With knobs on.
You are our sword, Cedric.
Cedric, is that your name? I never knew you had a name. My, what short arms you have, Parchester.
In this battle, you're either with us, or you are not with us.
Yeah, it's all for one and one for all.
And I'm for another drink.
Yeah, me and all.
Well, then I must be with you. We must present a united front.
Then what do you advise, Cedrico?
As the family solicitor, here's my advice to you. As the family solicitor...
That'll do, Parchester. Pay close attention.
William, I demand that you give up Sally at all costs.
You demand? Well, let us tell you something. Because we, oh yes, we... I demand that I marry Sally, or die an old maid, whatever they say. Where are they all gone?
William, pull yourself together and come here.
I won't come here.
Come here!
Shut! I intend to be master in my own house.
Listen to me!
No! You listen to me! You and the family can all go to blazes, and then the fat will be in the fire. The history of the airfit starts with me, and this is what I think of past history.
How dare you! This only shows how much you need a proper wife to teach you how to behave.
Sally
is the last person for that position. The last. Finally, and positively the last.
Great
deal. I just see Sally leaving in the car.
It's her, John.
She's made her go back to Lambeth.
I'll get Mariah back. I'll show her that it's wrong to part two lovers. And stand up to her!
Johnny. Johnny, I want to tell you something. You know Sally. She's my girl. I never loved anyone else. Well, you know, except you, of course.
Of course.
She's everything to me, John.
Me too. She's a hard battleship, but I love her.
What? Sally?
No! Mariah!
Oh, Johnny, why's everything spinning round? What have you done to this room, you little rascal?
Not me, old sport.
Yeah.
But why is everything turning round?
I know what it is.
The world keeps on turning. You can't stop it turning. It's love makes the world go round.
And old love and new love, as long as it's true love, it's love makes the world go round.
Without love, my little mammy, nobody would sing.
Without love,
no wedding bells ring.
And though people doubt it, they can't live without it. All over the world they found that love makes the world go round.
Don't. Here, I've written him a letter telling him not to look for me because he won't find me.
You want me to take a look at it? Well, it seems all wrong to me.
Sally, love, a telegram come for you.
From me? Oh, I bet it's from Bill.
Is it?
Yeah, what I tell you.
Stay put and fed up to the back teeth for being a nerd and throwing up everything and coming after. Love, Bill.
Now you see why I gotta go. Goodbye, Bob. Keep your fingers crossed for me.
Good luck, Sally.
Hello, Saucy.
What a good judge of character. Another time, perhaps. Ah, oh, here we are. Number 21.
Yes?
Good evening, madam. Does Miss Sally Smith live here?
Who wants her?
Well, say it's her fairy godfather.
Who?
Just take me into her.
Oh, no, you don't. Not in my house. Filthy beast. Sally, there's somebody here to see you.
Who is it?
Says he's your furry godfather.
Fairy, not furry.
It's all right, Sally. It's only me.
Come in. John, what are you doing here? It's all right, Mrs. Brown. This is a very dear friend of mine.
I'm sure. This is what comes from hobnobbing with the gentry.
Goodbye, fair spirit of morality.
It's no good, Sir John. I'm not going back. I'm going to move away. You're wasting your time.
But, Sally, I haven't come here to persuade you to go back.
You haven't?
No. We have got to beat the Duchess at her own game.
Yeah, well, the Duchess don't like me just because I'm not fit and proper.
But what if we could make you fit and proper?
Oh, get away. Besides, I wouldn't want that. But, well, supposing I did, how would you do it?
Oh, not me. But there's an army friend of mine shares a house in Upper Wimpole Street with a remarkable man who could certainly do it. He's done it before. And if you really love Bill, you'll let him try.
Only if you promise not to tell Bill where I am.
I promise.
Oh, well, we better go straight away then. Look, I'll run in and pack a few things.
Good girl. My car's at the end of the street.
All right.
Oh,
I'm sorry.
Oh, dear. I think I dropped something.
A couple of eaves, perhaps.
Well, so what if I was listening? So, it's for Sally's own good.
You are Mrs. Brown.
Mrs. Anastasia Brown, yes.
Well, Mrs. Anastasia Brown, you evidently heard that I'm going to take Sally away.
I heard the fairy tale you was telling the poor mite.
And you also heard that Sally doesn't want Bill to know where she's going.
No more do you, I don't suppose.
Do you know what this is, Mrs. Brown?
Sounds like a fiver.
What does it look like?
It's a £4 note!
Well done, Mrs. Brown. Here you are.
Ooh, thank you, sir.
And there's more where that came from, if you'll just keep your mouth shut when Bill comes for Sally.
I get you, sir. Mum's the word.
Good. Farewell, Mrs. Anastasia Brown. Ooh, not now, my dear. This is war, and I must rejoin my regiment.
I'd recognize that face anywhere, okay?
Oh, my God! I mean, oh, my Lord!
Oh, now, don't you start, Mrs. B. Hey, where's Sally?
She's gone, not here, gone.
Gone? What you mean, gone?
She didn't say. She went away, not coming back no more.
When?
When? Well, ages ago.
Here, did she get my wire, then?
Yes. No. Yes. That's what made her go.
She leave an address?
No address.
Then what about a mail?
Well, she'll collect it. I don't know.
Now you're telling me pork pies, Mrs. B. Is she in there?
She ain't here, I tell you. She's gone.
Yeah. Well, I've heard that one before. Oh, wait right here.
It's no good, Bill. She's never coming back.
Well, we'll see about that.
Now then, sir, I'm terribly afraid that you really can't stop here. Brother comes under the heading of loitering, waiting for someone.
Leaning on a lamp, maybe you think I look a tramp, or you might think I'm hanging round to steal a car. But no, I'm not a crook. And if you think that's what I look, I'll tell you why I'm here and what my motives are. I'm leaning on a lamppost at the corner of the street in case a certain little lady comes by. Oh, me. Oh, my. Oh, I hope that little lady comes by. She'll get away. She doesn't always get away. But anyway, I know that she'll try. Oh, me. Oh, my. I hope that little lady comes by. There's no other girl I could wait for. But this one I'd break any date for. I won't have to ask what she's late for. She wouldn't leave me flat. She's not a girl like that. She's absolutely wonderful and marvelous and beautiful, and anyone can understand why. I'm leaning on a lamppost at the corner of the street in case a certain little lady comes by.
Thank you.
your mum right there. Why? Coming your way.
Sad and little light.
have been moping for days. What's the matter? Bad news from your bookmaker?
Oh, John, I just despair of Bill. Since Sally went away, he's become impossible. He's wasted thousands on detectives to look for her. Newspaper advertisements offering huge rewards. Nothing.
Nothing.
And he's convinced I know where she is. I could almost wish the wretched girl back here.
Well, you never know. Perhaps she will come back. Stranger things have happened.
It's so dispiriting.
Mariah, I never thought I'd say this, but I preferred you when you were a ghastly old trout. Do cheer up.
Usually I buy myself a new hat when I'm down in the dumps.
So that's where you get them from.
I never realized how truly fond of Bill Sally is. I thought once she was out of the way, but no, he's done nothing but sulk.
She's just not the same, is he? But it's never too late. I knew a couple once who secretly loved one another for 30 years.
30 years?
31 years, 7 months, and 3 days. Their love was so secret, they weren't even aware of it themselves.
And what happened?
Well, they struggled along miserably, until one day, the man took it into his head, after all this time, to get down on one knee, not unlike this, and say in his simple, direct, and manly way, I can't move!
I can't move?
Damn it, Mariah, my leg's seized up. Hit my back. Ooh, a bit higher. Harder, to the left. That's it. Oh, damn shrapnel. Always gives me a twinge when I get worked up. Now, where was I?
This couple. The man was about to propose.
Oh, Mariah.
Oh, John. Oh, yeah.
What?
No, no, no. No, 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 no.
Oh, good heavens. Heatherset. You here?
Yes, sir.
Women, Heatherset.
Yes, sir.
Have you ever been in love, Heatherset?
Oh, no, sir. I'm married.
Oh, I didn't realize that.
Yes, sir, to the cook. My, you were kind enough to attend the ceremony.
Well, be that as it may. Yes, sir. Is she here yet?
I beg your pardon, sir.
Is she here yet?
Oh, yes, sir, I put her where you told me.
What?
I put her where you told me to.
Oh, good man. And remember, not a word to anyone.
No, sir.
Heatherset. Where's Lord Hereford?
I believe he is in his bedroom, my lady.
Bedroom? What's he doing?
I believe he is packing, my lady.
Packing? What on earth is he packing for?
He did not confide in me, my lady.
I told you so.
I'm going to have it out with him once and for all. Heatherset?
My lady?
Ask Lord Hereford to come here, please.
Very good, my lady.
Well, frankly, Jackie, you're making a complete ass of yourself chasing after Bill Hereford after all this time. You know perfectly well he's done nothing but search for Sally. Will you give up this nonsense and marry me?
Marry you? With all your debts? Ha!
Well, as a matter of fact, I don't have any debts. You see, Bill was good enough to write me a big check.
Only, only all fresh, ripe strawberries. You rang, madam?
What is the meaning of this?
Oh, Mummy. Oh, William, you're not really planning to go.
And what's more, I'm going. Unless the Duchess produces Sally.
How many times do I have to tell you? Sally, Sally, and what about me? I'm not to be cast aside lightly.
No, you should be thrown with great force.
But don't you feel something when we're together?
Well, I feel ill.
But I thought you cared for me.
Oh, no, I couldn't care for you. I'm just an ordinary earl, not a vet.
Ha, 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 ha!
Let me tell you, I wouldn't marry you now if you were the last man on Earth.
Well, if I was the last man on Earth, I'd be too busy to marry anybody.
I say, that was a slap in the face.
Aye.
It would have served her right if you'd slapped her in the face.
Yeah, well, it's not a face that wants slapping.
Yes, but you couldn't very well...
Oh, yeah. She'll marry the first man who does.
She will.
Aye.
I say, do you really think so?
Yeah.
I'd never thought of that.
Tally-ho!
Gerald!
William! Where are you planning to go?
Lambeth, Auntie.
Oh, this is madness, madness. Oh! Haven't I done enough for you? Haven't I thrown parties for you?
At me?
Oh. Well, you must have a son to ensure the succession. Better still, lots of sons.
You've got a mind like a gerbil.
Well, you can't leave now, not after all I've achieved.
I can if you don't tell me where Sally is.
But I don't know where she is. Oh, Gerald!
Who? Well, then tomorrow morning, every picture palace in London will show a newsreel of Lord Airford returning to Lambeth.
I say, you'll never guess what's happened. Jacqueline has promised to be my trouble and strife.
No! Oh! Sorry. Now, I'm going back to Lambeth to make Sally my wife.
To make the same mistake as your father.
The only mistake he made was to leave his girl. I shan't. I'm sorry, Auntie Duchess. You seem to have lost your little battle.
I hope I am not ungracious in defeat. You may kiss your aunt.
No. You may kiss your nevy.
Goodbye, Bill. You're a true Hereford.
Noblesse oblige. Right. I'm off to finish packing. Cheerio, everybody.
Gerald, go fetch him back quick.
What for?
You'll see.
Hey!
Oh, give me that thing.
Miss Sally Smith.
Oh, what?
How do you do, Your Grace? Lady Jacqueline, such a pleasure. Gentlemen.
I think she's got it.
We are all of us susceptible to the right treatment, Your Grace.
You, John! John, you! Oh, my goodness! Sally, does Bill know?
Not yet.
He's on his way!
William, I have a very special friend I'd like you to meet.
How do you do, Lord Hereford?
Yeah, how do you do? Charlie, bring the car around, please, Garth.
Do I take it you're going somewhere, Lord Hereford? What are those two bags doing?
Well, they live here. Right. I'm packed and I'm off.
Back to Lambeth, I suppose.
That's right. To find Sally.
It seems to me, Lord Hereford, and you will forgive me for saying so, that you must be extremely fond of this gal to give everything up for her like this.
If you only knew how much I wanted her to come back.
And if she does come back, Lord Hereford, what on earth will you say to her after all this time?
What'll I say? Well, I'll say, well, I'll say... Where the bloody hell have you been?